is good, Lord, to be here. Your glory fills the night. Your face and garments like the sun shine with unborrowed light. 'Tis good, Lord, to be here. Your beauty
Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, in the Transfiguration, Peter, James, and John have their eyes opened to the glory of Jesus as the beloved Son of God. For the times we have not recognized Christ in our midst, let us pause to ask for mercy and pardon.
I confess to Almighty God,
to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Mary, ever virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who have commanded us to listen to your beloved Son, be pleased, we pray, to nourish us inwardly by your word, that with spiritual sight made pure, we may rejoice to behold your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God put Abraham to the test. He called to him, "Abraham." "Here I am," he replied. Then God said, "Take your son Isaac, your only one, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah. There you shall offer him up as a holocaust on a height that I will point out to you. When they came to the place of which God had told him, Abraham built an altar there and arranged the wood on it. Then he reached out and took the knife to slaughter his son. But the Lord's messenger called to him from heaven, Abraham, Abraham. Here I am, he answered. Do not lay your hand on the boy, said the messenger. Do not do the least thing to him. I know now that you are devoted to God, since you did not withhold from me your own beloved son. As Abraham looked about, he spied a ram caught by its horns in the thicket. So he went and took the ram and offered it as a holocaust in place of his son. Again, the Lord's messenger called to Abraham from heaven and said, I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you acted as you did in not withholding from me your beloved son, I will bless you abundantly and make your descendants as countless as the stars of the sky and the sands of the seashore. Your descendants shall take possession of the gates of their enemies, and in your descendants all nations of the earth shall find blessings. All this because you obeyed my command. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, if God is for us, Who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all, how will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? Christ Jesus it is who died, or rather was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus took Peter, James, and John and led them up a high mountain apart from themselves, by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his clothes became dazzling white, such as no fuller on earth could bleach them. Then Elijah appeared to them along with Moses, and they were conversing with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, "Rabbi, it is good that we are here. Let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He hardly knew what to say. They were so terrified. Then a cloud came, casting a shadow over them. From the cloud came a voice, "This is my beloved Son. Listen to him." Suddenly, looking around, they no longer saw anyone but Jesus alone with them. As they were coming down from the mountain, he charged them not to relate what they had seen to anyone, except when the Son of Man had risen from the dead. So they kept the matter to themselves, questioning what rising from the dead meant. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today I want to relate what the sacrifice and transfiguration, understanding of the transfer of power. In the first reading, Abraham was given a test, and we might think, man, that's a horrific thing, to test your love by sacrificing your children. But you have to understand, in those days, you must put yourself in that thought process. The logic of an undeveloped society, tribal instincts, those were times of human sacrifice. They felt a need to give Earth a self-created God of their understanding, a life, something of value, something of spirit. Personal sacrifices were made in times of extreme crises or to signify a new beginning. Children were the ultimate sacrifice because of how precious they were. The act was not considered murder because of the high value that they put on human life and the certainty that the dynasties would care for them in the afterlife. Yes, they did believe in the afterlife. The readings said that God guided Abraham to test him by asking for his son. And in the last seconds, he sends a message. You passed. You passed. But here, sacrifice this ram. There will be no more human sacrifices. Now in the gospel, Peter, James, and John looked up and saw Jesus with Moses and Elijah. They couldn't hear what they were talking about. What do you think they were talking about? A picture that speaks a thousand words. Now Peter, James, and John were given front row seats to the Transfiguration. The Transfiguration was the inauguration of a new covenant. It is here the old covenant is recognized but no longer has precedence. The new covenant will take over, and with a promising, hopeful future, just as it happened with Abraham. Inauguration. What is an inauguration? The beginning of an introduction of a system, a policy, a period, the initiation of an institution, new covenant, setting up, a launch, an establishment, the formal admissions of someone to office. A ceremony to mark the beginning of something and also the end of an old covenant. A successful transfer of power. The old ways of Moses, the sacrifice of animals, will no longer be needed. We have the ultimate sacrifice, the Lamb of God, who will take away the sins of the world. Elijah and all the prophecies have been fulfilled. We have Christ, the Messiah, Savior of the world. There are a lot of groups out there that don't believe that Jesus is legitimate. Even though they have seen all the evidence, my take, Moses and Elijah were probably telling Jesus, they'd rather hang you to the cross than believe you are the Son of God. Again, a voice comes from the heaven to solidify and confirm and said, this is my beloved Son. Listen to him.
We stand as a people who listen to the Son as we proclaim our faith in the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. In today's second reading, St. Paul writes, "If God is for us, who can be against us? Secure in the love of our merciful Father, let us turn to him with our needs and petitions."
The response to our prayer is, "Heal us, O Lord." For the church, that we may be transfigured in love, conform ever more fully to the heart and mind of Jesus Christ, we pray,
"Heal us, O Lord."
For renewal of our society, that God will heal those wounded by prejudice and injustice, and help everyone to work together for the common good, we pray,
Heal us, O Lord.
For our candidates for confirmation, that they may come to a deeper appreciation of their baptism into Christ's death and resurrection, we pray,
Heal us, O Lord.
For enlightenment on our Lenten journey, that as we participate in sacrificial practices during this Lenten season, we may make more room in our life for God, the giver of all life, we pray.
Heal us, O Lord.
For those who are sick, that Christ will radiate his healing light, especially for Father Joe Tito and Kathy Thibault. We pray.
Heal us, O Lord.
For our beloved dead, that they will walk in the presence of God for all eternity, especially Linda Braun. We pray.
Heal us, O Lord.
For those unable to worship with us in person, for whom this Mass is being offered, and for all our intentions, spoken and unspoken, we pray.
Heal us, O Lord.
Faithful God, we look to you in our need and listen closely to hear your voice. Bless us as the descendants of your servant Abraham, and heal and hear these prayers we make today in the name of your Son and our Savior, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Longing for light, we wait in darkness. Longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your own, your holy people, light for the world to see. Christ, be our longing for hope, many despair. Your word alone has power to save us. Make us your living voice. Christ, be our light. Shine in our hearts. Shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light. Shine in your church gathered today. Longing for food, many are hungry. Longing for water, many still thirst. Make us your bread, broken for others, shared until all are fed. Christ, be our light. Shine in our hearts, shine
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for praise and glory of his holy name, for our good and for all his holy church.
May this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, cleanse us of our faults and sanctify your faithful in body and mind for the celebration of the Paschal festivities through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them
up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after he had told the disciples of his coming death, on the holy mountain he manifested to them his glory, to show even by the testimony of the law and the prophets that the passion leads to the glory of the resurrection. And so, with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth and before your majesty without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name.
Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you've created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, By the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with this Holy Spirit may become one body, one Spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Blaise our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you in your compassion, O merciful Father. Gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our spiritual communion prayer for those at home. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Transfigure us, O Lord, transfigure us, O Lord. Break the chains that bind us, speak your healing word, and where you lead, we'll follow. Transfigure us, O Lord. Down from heights of glory, into the depths below, the love of God self-emptied, the love of God to show. You light the path before us, the way that we must go. Transfigure us, O Lord.
chains that bind us. Speak your healing word, and where you lead we'll follow. Transfigure us, O Lord. Light for those in darkness, the hungry have their fill. Glad tidings for the humble, the healing of our ills. In these we glimpse your glory, God's promises fulfilled. Transfigure us, O Lord, transfigure us, O Lord. Break the chains that bind us, speak your healing word, and where you lead we'll follow. Transfigure us, O Lord.
Let us pray. Bless your faithful, we pray, O Lord, with a blessing that endures forever. As we receive these glorious mysteries, we make thanksgiving to you, O Lord, for allowing us, while still on earth, to be partakers, even now, of the things of heaven, through Christ our Lord. Amen. So as we can see outside, we have, seems at least for a few moments, we have spring on our side. So let us enjoy each and every day these gifts that God has given us. Even if you're not able still to come out, make a call to somebody. Wish them a well to bring spring into all our hearts, and that soon we will all be together. So we continue to pray here at St. Mary's for all those who have yet to receive the vaccine. And we pray for those who are still ill and for those families who are still affected by COVID-related illnesses for this last year. So let us keep everyone in mind that we were walking this journey together, as the disciples did, as they came down off, they went into their new mission. And so that will be our mission, even in this time of separation, isolation. The Lord be with you. Bless your faithful, we pray, O Lord, with a blessing that endures forever. And keep them faithful to the gospel of your only begotten Son, so that they may always desire and at last attain that glory whose beauty he showed in his own body to the amazement of his apostles, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. This Mass has ended.
Thanks be to God.
Wasting, you rule day and night. Your Thy justice, like mountains, high soaring.